Hi, this is John Chen. Welcome to the Top Team Fixes for Team Fails, Secrets from a Professional Team Builder. I've had the privilege of learning and sharing the best ideas of team building and leadership from the most successful people in the world, and watching them applied to over 950 team building events with 50,000 people from Fortune 500 companies such as Microsoft, Booz Allen Hamilton, and U.S. Bancorp. In addition, these fixes come from watching team after team fail, as well as those amazing but rare teams who perform amazing feats and ascend higher than any other team. Each of these fails and fixes are battle-tested from our 950 team-building events, from the meeting room to the boardrooms around the world. Now, how does a software engineer get into team-building? So just a little history about myself. I spent 10 years at Microsoft, and then during that time, I got the chance to ship over 10 products and earn 2 U.S. patents during the process. And that's when I gained my huge passion for experiential team-building. So what we did with that is that during that time, we worked on a lot of different projects, but one of the key ones was Exchange. And that was the world's first client-server email project. And what happened was that it had a lot of failed leadership. It went through 7 different leaders during the course of 8 years. But eventually, they found one key leader. His name was Brian Valentine, and he's the one who drove that to change. So then Exchange was a combination or a collaboration of 8 different projects that were bought or acquired or developed internally and all brought together. And so what happened was the first time that they put this server together, they sent one email to 10 different people. And what happened is that the computer did not return control to you for 24 hours. We had a slight performance problem. So what happened is that Brian Valentine at the time created a performance team. He selected 14 different people, of which I was one of the key leaders, and he brought us all into a room. And he gave us this one key assignment. He brings us in and he says, "We have a slight performance problem, and now it's your job to fix it." And in traditional Brian Valentine and Microsoft style, he then gets up and walks out of the room. Now, all of us are all standing there in the room and looking at each other going, "Well, what are we going to do?" At that point, we just have to figure it out. And the first thing that you do, of course, when you have a multi-team project and something's not working, is that we did the classic thing. We blamed all the other teams. So we went in there and we went to each of the teams and said, "Prove to us, you know, that you're fast for what you're doing." And we were looking for them to be slow in something. But when all the results came back is that each component was very fast for what they were designed for. So we had to take a different tact to this. And so with our team building knowledge, we took this different tact. And with the technical knowledge that I had, I worked with a guy on the server. And what we ended up building was a conversation log. It was basically all the communication between all the different teams put into a process map. And this turned out to be a piece of gold because then we could find out how much conversation was really going on when you were trying to do simple things. So let's take a very simple action, such as reading a piece of email. Now, that should be something that you do quite a bit, and it should be something very simple to do. But guess how many round trips to the server it took to read just one piece of email? Go ahead and guess. 1? No. 2? More. 4? Even more. 8? Even more. 16? Even more. 32? You still don't have enough. It took 43 trips to the server to read one piece of email. For those of you who are not technical, it's like this. Imagine if you had 43 $1 bills sitting on your counter at home, and you pick one of them up, and you get in your car, and you drive to the bank, and then you write out a deposit slip, you deposit that dollar into the bank, and then you drive home, and you pick up another one, and you do this over 42 times. Yeah, this is really efficient. So what happened to that is that was our big opportunity for improving performance. And so what we did is we took this key information and invited leaders from each one of the teams to a meeting. So they came into this and then there was this conversation map sitting in front of them. And I opened the speech with this and saying, "You know, I'll never be as smart as each one of you and I'll never know each one of your components as well as each one of you do. All I know is that we're in charge of performance and that we have a problem to fix. And this is what's happening. So I'm relying on each one of you to figure out what the problem is and see if you can solve it." And what I did was I sat down.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.